Hi, it's Jamal here from Aviation Guy channel. Today we will talk about a subject that has been on your minds. Have you ever wondered why some planes have pointy bits at their ends of the wings? Before getting deep into winglets, you may follow me on my other social media accounts. Have you ever looked out your plane window and wondered why the hell those curly little bits at the ends of the wings were for? Winglets are those small upturned tips at the end of an aircraft wings, and they have become an increasingly common sight on passenger aircraft this century. The developments of winglets as we see them today started during the 1973 oil crisis. The Arab states put oil embargo on the United States for providing aid to Israel for Yom Kippur War. This caused the oil prices skyrocket, forcing engineers to get creative to reduce fuel consumptions. Richard Whitcomb paid lots of attention on this thought. Parts of his inspiration came from birds that curl their wings feathers up while gliding to achieve more lift. So he got to work this testing theory and found that it worked exactly as he expected. Let's take a look at the science. As you know, planes fly by developing high pressure air under their wings and low pressure air above. Fluids will always flow from high pressure regions to low pressure regions, and these can cause problems at the wingtips. High pressure air from below the wing will bleed into the low pressure air above, creating mini tornadoes of the tips of the wing. This is called induced drag, and it decreases the lift of the wing and increases the fuel consumptions of the airplane. Winglets reduce the airflow by reducing pressure gradient at the tips of the wing, thus making the vortices much smaller. Their ultimate goal is to create a lift distribution across the wing in the shape of an ellipse. This minimizes the amount of air that wants to flow over the wingtips while maintaining the maximum lift. Winglets are just one way to do this. Boeing's latest airplane, 787 Dreamliner, has done away with wingtips in favor of a racket wingtip, which sweeps the tip of the wing backwards. Boeing said that their racket wingtips have improved the fuel efficiency by 5.5% to 4.5% for conventional wingtips. There are many forces which influence the amount of aerodynamic drag which a body generates. Drag depends on the shape, size, inclination of the subject, and on flow conditions of the air passing the object. As we mentioned, for a three-dimensional wing, there is an additional component of drag. This is called induced drag, or drag due to lift. Induced drag is a three-dimensional effect related to the distribution of lift across the wing. Flow near the wingtips have a strong influence on the amount of induced drag because of the tip vortices that are generated there. The aspect ratio is the ratio of the square of a span to the wing area. Induced drag is inversely related to the aspect ratio of the wing. Long, thin wings have low induced drag. Wings with elliptical planform have also lower induced drag than rectangular wings, as expressed in the efficiency factor in the induced drag equation. There are many sorts of winglets. Let's take a look at them. Conventional upright winglets are currently used on a number of airlines, including Boeing 747-400s or Airbus 330-340s. On some of its 737 models, Boeing prefers blended winglets, which curve up from the wing instead of sticking straight up. Blended winglets. You will find blended winglets on many models of Boeing 737, the best-selling jetliner in the world. The Southwest and Ryanair are the biggest operators, and you will often see them in North America at the tip of 737 wings with WestJet, Delta, and American. They are called blended winglets because they feature a much smoother transition from the wing itself to the winglet, which produces additional efficiencies compared to a canted winglet or wingtip fence. Those are also the winglets worn on most Boeing 757s and 767s in service today. They are not installed originally when the planes left the factory, but have been retrofitted by most operators, including American, Delta, United. At 11 feet tall, the 767 winglets are a sight to behold, and the ones on 737s and 757s are just a bit shorter, at 8 feet 2 inches. Guys, if you like the video, you may consider giving a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And also you may comment below about any topics that you want to see in the next videos. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.